Let us start with the activity. In the following, this figure 3.1, DE is a chord of a circle with center C. CF is perpendicular to DE. Diameter is 20. Diameter is 20. DE is 16. Find CF. So recall the property, perpendicular from center to the chord, it bisects the chord. So if DE is 16, how much is DF? It is 8. How much is FE? This is 8. Join CD. CD is radius of the circle. Diameter is 20, so radius is 10. In triangle DCF, angle F is 90 degree. So DC 10 square minus this 8 square, that is 100 minus 64, you have 36, that is 6. So this CF is 6. So complete this statement. The perpendicular drawn from center to the chord, it bisects the chord. So this is one of the activity which you have to complete and write it in your activity copy. Second activity, in this given figure, QR is chord of a circle with center O. P is midpoint of the chord QR. QR is 24. OP is perpendicular distance, not perpendicular distance, distance OP is given to be 10. Find the radius of the circle. You have to find out OQ. So here it is given, P is midpoint. So segment joining midpoint of the chord and center of the circle. So it is perpendicular to the chord. So which theorem you are using here? Segment joining midpoint of the chord with center of the circle. So this is OP. Now OP is perpendicular to QR. You join OQ, and here QP is 12, OP is 10. Find out OQ by applying Pythagoras theorem. This is your second activity. This activity also you have to write it in your activity copy. Start with next activity. M is center of the circle. AB is diameter. MS perpendicular to AD, this is given to you. MT perpendicular to AC, this is given to you. Angle DAB congruent with angle CAB. You have to prove chord AD congruent with chord AC. Now, observe triangle ASM and triangle ATM. Angle DAB congruent to angle CAB, which means angle SAM congruent to angle TAM. SM is perpendicular, so MS is perpendicular to AD, so angle S is 90. MT is perpendicular to AC, so angle T is 90. AM is common side, so triangle SAM congruent to triangle TAM by side angle angle test. Right? So SM congruent with MT, corresponding sides of congruent triangles. And AS congruent with AT, corresponding sides of congruent triangles. Okay, so two triangles are congruent by SAA test. So perpendicular from center, SM congruent with MT, which means chords which are equidistant from the center are equal in length. This you are using over here. So AS congruent with AT, perpendicular from center to the chord, it bisects the chord. So AS is equal to SD, and therefore AS plus SD is same as AT plus TC, that is AD congruent with AC. Circle passing through 1, 2 and 3 points. Circle with center P, circle with center R and circle with center Q. Observe, point A lies in a plane. All three circles with center P, Q and R passes through this point A. How many such circles can pass through this point A? So what is your answer? Innumerable circles, infinitely many circles can pass through this point A. To observe this, perform the activity. Draws any segment AB. Draw perpendicular bisector of this segment AB, that is line L. Select any point P on this line L, and with P as a center and PA as radius, draw a circle which will pass through this AB. Select another point Q on the line L. With QA as radius, draw a circle which will pass through this AB. Select another point RST on the same line L and observe that all these circles will pass through this line AB. So how many such circles you can draw passing through this line AB? Infinitely many circles can be drawn passing through these points A and B. And where is the center? Center will lie on line L. Center will lie on line L.